Today we will continue with writer, and today we will first feature that today we will learn that will be your columns feature. Had you tried columns in MS Word? Anybody who had tried columns in MS Word? Yes. Anybody? Divya, Jayati, Laksh, Jashan, Dhiren, anybody from D class section? Anybody who had tried columns using columns in MS Word? No one. Okay, that is a very beautiful feature, very good feature that we can use to save the page. For example, I want to make a write a text like in a newspaper columns, in the way of newspaper column. By default, there is a single column. Our text continues towards the in the full width, cover the full width of the page. But we can divide the page into two or three columns, like we can see in a newspaper columns. As a newspaper का एक news आ रहा है, and particular एक box में अगर news है, तो that is divided into two or three columns, right? So for that we can also divide our text, maybe the selected text, maybe the whole document, maybe the few portion of few pages of the document, that we can divide in columns, maybe to save the page also, or to present the topic in that way also. So columns can be divided by using the format menu, column option. This option is available in MS Word also, and in a much more better way. Okay, format menu, column option, a column dialog box will appear. Choose the various settings, that how many number of columns you want. Have used text boxes, not the column, but a column work differently. Text box ke ilawa different work karte hain, because our text automatically moves to the next column when it comes to the end. टेक्स्ट बॉक्सेस में यू हैव टू स्पेसिफाई कि कितना टेक्स्ट बॉक्स का साइज होगा एंड कितना आपका उसका टेक्स्ट जो है वो एक बॉक्स में आएगा. सो फॉर दैट पर्पस आई विल शो यू कि कैसे मैं कॉलम्स को भी यूटिलाइज करके दिखा रही हूँ आपको कि कैसे आप इसको प्रैक्टिकली यूज कर सकते हो बहुत अच्छे तरीके से. देन कॉलम डायलॉग बॉक्स will appear. In that column dialog box, you will make the required changes, such as ki how many number of columns you want, what will be the width of those columns, whether you want to display the line in between the columns or not, and then you click on OK. Okay. Now I'm going to share my writer window. Okay. Here. Just a minute. Who had entered? Okay. In this window, I'm having a few examples like this. Okay, I'm having this also. A list. मेरे पास कुछ list बनी हुई है options की. Like this list is there. Standard toolbar के buttons हैं. यहाँ पे मेरे पास formatting toolbar के buttons हैं. तो I can, what I can do, I can divide this text in two columns so that the half of the page will be saved. ठीक है, अगर यही चीज मेरे पास मुझे नजर आ रही है कि ये मेरी बहुत ज्यादा लंबी एक ही लिस्ट नजर आ रही है, बनी जा रही है, पूरे पेज पे कवर हो रही है, आई कैन डिवाइड दिस लिस्ट, आई कैन डिवाइड दिस सिलेक्टेड टेक्स्ट इन टू कॉलम, सो दैट द टेक्स्ट विल अपीयर इन टू कॉलम, द हाफ ऑफ द पेज कैन बी सेव्ड एंड इट ऑल्सो लुक्स गुड. वी कैन सेलेक्ट द टेक्स्ट दैट यू वॉन्ट टू डिवाइड इन टू कॉलम, दैट यू वॉन्ट टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट इन टू कॉलम्स. सेलेक्ट द टेक्स्ट, गो टू फॉर्मेट मेन्यू, choose the column option. Then here it is a by default this column 1. Now I click on 2. You can also click on 3 or 4. Or this is the right column, this is a left column. Right column means in which the right side column is small and left side column is bigger width wise. And similarly two columns with left to right, where left column is small and right column is a bigger one. This can be used in the case of index और सम अदर, जिसमें हमने कुछ पॉइंट्स हेडिंग्स लिखने हैं और सेकंड कॉलम में हमने उसको एक्सप्लेन करना है, दैट कैन आल्सो बी यूज्ड. बट प्रेजेंटली आई एम गोइंग टू यूज ओनली टू कॉलम्स. नाउ इवनली डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द कंटेंट्स टू अ कॉलम, इवनली डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करने हैं दोनों कॉलम्स, और यू वॉन्ट टू स्पेसिफाई द विड्थ योरसेल्फ, बोथ द थिंग्स कैन बी डन. इफ आई से इवनली डिस्ट्रीब्यूट, ओके, देन देयर इज अ सेपरेटर लाइन, वेदर यू वॉन्ट टू डिस्प्ले द लाइन, वट विल बी द विड्थ ऑफ द लाइन, or you do not want to display the line, none. By default it is none. I click on OK. Then most important, apply to selection. Presently I have selected the text before using the column option, so it is giving me apply to selection. If I place my cursor anywhere, then it will have the, you have to select the option, keep this point forward or to the whole document. I can click OK. Now you can see टेक्स्ट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू कॉलम्स अलोंग विद द बुलेट्स. बट अगर आप कहो कि मैं यहाँ पे टैब देके यूज कर सकता हूँ, ये मैं टैब देके यूज कर लेती हूँ कि आधी कॉलम आधे ऑप्शंस यहाँ लिखे आधे ऑप्शंस टैब देके मैं नेक्स्ट लिख लेते हैं, बट यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू गिव बुलेट्स टू ऑल व्हेन यूज द टैब बिकॉज बुलेट्स विल बी गिवन इन अ सिंगल रो. अगर मैं यहाँ पर टैब देके लिखूंगी, जैसे मुझे यहाँ पे लिखना है स्टाइल, इफ आई गिव टैब लाइक दिस, तो दिस इज अ सिंगल लाइन. So if I give the bullets, the bullet will be applied only to the first style. It will not be applied to the formatting like this. Okay, it will not come here. आप इसको बुलेट अलग से नहीं देख सकते because this is a single line. एक ही लाइन में आ रहा है टेक्स्ट. So here we are dividing the column in different, dividing the text in different columns. And I can do the formatting as it is a separate line. Okay? Clear? Columns clear? Or shall I give you the one more time? Select the text. Suppose I'm selecting this now. I'm dividing it. Format menu. Column option. Choose column. Suppose this time I'm taking 3. Evenly distribute. Click on OK. And if you want to display a line, click on OK. Now you can see here it is a line also. Nazar aa raha hai sabko? Is it visible now? Okay, here we had divided into two columns. Here we had not taken the equal column width. That is why the width is different. Or you can place your cursor anywhere, and before typing also you can divide the text into column, divide the page into columns. Format menu, column option, okay, page style convert 3. If I say 2, click on OK. Now whole column is divided into two columns. Whole document is divided into columns. Yeah, many jo aapka page aa raha last wala, that is divided into two columns. Better you select the text, type the text, select it, and then divide it into columns. It will be easily arranged in different columns. Okay? Okay, next we will do. If you want to ask anything, you can ask about this. Next is alignment. We had already used alignments many times. Third, fourth class, we are using the alignments. Alignment means placing the text or the position of the text on a page with respect to the margins. With respect to the margins of the document, whether my text is towards the right margin, whether my text is towards the right margin, or it is in between the dividing equally between the left and right margin, that is called the alignment or placement of the text. Four types of alignments are there: left align, right align, center align, and justify. Left align means the text will be aligned towards the left side of the page, towards the left margin, and right align means towards the right margin. And center align means equally distribute the page, equal distance from the left and right margin. And justify means, what is the meaning of justify?
Ma'am, equal distance from left and right margin.
No, it evenly, that is for center alignment, evenly. Justify means evenly distribute the text between the left and right margin. Okay, so that both the sides will be same, will remain equal. It doesn't look ragged. आपका जो रैग्ड ऑप्शन आपका नजर आता है, यान इक्वल नजर आती है लेफ्ट साइड राइट साइड, दैट शुड नॉट बी लाइक दिस. लाइक हियर इट इज आई हैड यूज्ड द जस्टिफाई अलाइनमेंट. ठीक है, यहाँ पर देखो बोथ लेफ्ट एंड राइट साइड पे आपका इक्वल आ रहा है. इफ आई टेक इट एज अ लेफ्ट, नाउ यू कैन सी यहाँ पर सॉफ्टवेयर के बाद डिस्टेंस ज्यादा है, ग्राफिक्स के बाद कम है, कॉमन के बाद और भी ज्यादा आ रहा है. सो व्हेन आई गिव इट जस्टिफाई, it will be equally distributed, text is equally distributed between the left and right margins. Evenly distributed, equally nahi, sorry, evenly distributed. Theek hai, clear? Okay, next is line spacing. Line spacing means, anybody? The vertical distance between two lines of text. Whenever we are writing the text, we are writing the paragraphs, what is the distance between these two lines? This distance is called line spacing. Usually, there are three types of line spacing in the MS in Writer. That is a single line spacing. Line spacing is a calculated or line spacing is measured in the in points. So by default, there is a single line spacing and it is measured as 12 points. And it could be 1.5 line spacing or 1.5 line spacing, that will be 18 points. And double line spacing, that will be of 24 points, the distance between two lines of text. Okay, there are two methods to change the line spacing. One is format menu paragraph option. In paragraph option, there are many tabs. You can use the use indentation and spacing tab. जो हमने कल use किया था indent set करने के लिए, same tab can be used for in line spacing also. And second method is click on line spacing 1 or line spacing 1.5 or line spacing 2. There are three buttons on formatting toolbar. Okay. See, here I'm selecting the text. I'm going to format menu, paragraph. This is the indents and spacing tab. This is the line spacing option. Click here, you will find single, 1.5, double. By default, ये जो three हैं, इनके buttons भी आपको बाहर मिलेंगे. Otherwise, you can have the proportional, at least, leading, fixed. Here you have to give the points. You have to give in whether in percentage or in points. Suppose I'm taking it as single. Click OK. The line spacing is reduced. There is a distance. Now, देखो दोनों में difference है. यहाँ पर line spacing कम है, यहाँ पे line spacing ज़्यादा है. Similarly, I can go to this again. Format, paragraph. We can have the double. Okay. Now it is the line spacing, double line spacing. It all depends on your topic. आपको क्या topic है, कैसे आपको present करना है, कितना पेज पे कवर करना है, दैट ऑल डिपेंड्स ऑन यू कि हाउ मच लाइन स्पेसिंग यू वांट. इफ यू वांट, यू कैन गिव पैराग्राफ लाइन स्पेसिंग फिक्स्ड और एट लीस्ट. हियर यू हैव टू गिव इन पॉइंट्स, यू हैव टू टाइप द नंबर एट लीस्ट कितना. तो दिस इज योर हिट एंड ट्रायल मेथड. यू कैन टाइप द नंबर, यू कैन सी कि कितना आ रहा है, उसे इंक्रीज करना है या उसे डिक्रीज करना है. सपोज आई एम गिविंग इट 20, will be 20 centimeters. It is given in centimeters. I can give it another, suppose 2, it is 2 centimeters. Okay. It is easy if we use only the by default three options are there. They are easily used. Here you can find in the formatting toolbar, there is a line spacing button. But if it is not available, you can click here down arrow. Here the option is visible buttons. Okay? आपके पास यहाँ पर एक आ रही है वैसे. Visible buttons में check करो, जो buttons आपके selected हैं, they are visible on formatting toolbar. And if the buttons is not selected, they are not visible on the formatting toolbar. You can hide and you can show the various buttons on formatting toolbar as according to your requirement. Here you can see superscript, subscript buttons are not available on the toolbar. Here line spacing 1.5. Now I had added. Now similarly, I'm going to add two also, double also, line spacing 2. Here it is added. Now there are three buttons available on line spacing. I can choose here. This. Okay. Similarly, we can have other buttons also. Select all, character, format, paragraph, left to right, right to left. Buttons are there. Okay. And if you want to hide any button, you can deselect that button. That button will be hidden from the formatting toolbar. Clear? Is it clear? Any doubt till now? Okay, next topic is that we will do today after line spacing is page orientation. Page orientation means we had already done in MS Word also. What do you mean by page orientation? You can unmute yourself.
Landscape and portrait.
Yes?
Landscape and portrait.
They are the two types of orientation, but what do you mean by orientation? the direction of the page, whether we are using the page lengthwise or whether we are using the page widthwise. ठीक है, orientation refers to whether the text is to be printed lengthwise or widthwise. If the text is printed or typed lengthwise, that is the portrait orientation, that is the by default orientation that we use. And if we want to print the text widthwise, that will be your landscape orientation. And how to set the orientation or how to change the orientation by clicking on format menu, page option, format menu में जैसे मैं paragraph option use करी है, paragraph के tabs use करे हैं, similarly we can use the page option and there will be the settings are related to the page like margins, header footer, orientation, size, all the options are there. Page style dialog box will appear. In that page style dialog box, click on page tab and then use the orientation. See, format menu, page option, here many of our tabs are there, organizer, page, background, header, footer, border, columns, footnotes. ठीक है, go to the page, here orientation option is there. This is portrait or landscape. Here size, form page ka size kitna hai, width or height kitni hai, then orientation. By default portrait, if we click on landscape, then click on OK. Page settings apply to the whole document. Mind it, page settings always apply to the whole document. Okay. I can zoom out. Okay, now go to the format page. I'm changing it again to portrait. Clear? Okay, margins and indentations humne kal kiye. Is there any problem in that? Okay, cursor movements. Next topic is cursor movements. All of you know that.
Ma'am.
Yes.
मैम जो आपने कॉलम जिस पेज पे आपने कॉलम्स लगाए थे उस पर लैंडस्केप व्यू नहीं लगा, ओरिएंटेशन लगा उस पे क्यों नहीं लगा था?
बिकॉज़ मैंने चेक करा, मैं अभी वही चेक कर रही थी ओरिएंटेशन वेदर इट इज अप्लाइंग टू द होल डॉक्यूमेंट और वेदर इट इज अप्लाइंग टू द सिलेक्टेड पेजेस दैट आई विल चेक. ठीक है, मैं चेक करके बताती हूँ. ओके, now I was talking about cursor movements. Okay, all of you are typing the text in word processor, chahe MS Word hai ya Writer hai, you are moving the cursor. But when you do a lots of work, jab aapka kaam zyada hota hai typing ke liye, you need the shortcut keys, you need the keys that will quickly move your cursor from one position to another. By default all of you are using the arrow keys, that is fine. Theek hai, all of you are using the arrow keys, up arrow key, left arrow key, right arrow key. You had learned a few shortcut keys in the previous classes also, but you are not using them. Many of you are not using them, I know that. But if you use them, that will be very, very easy to move the cursor. For example, I want to select the text to make the size bigger, or I want to select the text to, or I want to move the text to the beginning of the line instantly. I want to move the text to the beginning of the document, or I want to move the text cursor to the end of the document instantly. There are many keys which you can use instead of scrolling with the mouse or by using the mouse again and again. Keyboard use karna sabse zyada easy hota hai computer pe kaam karne ke liye. आपका काम की स्पीड बढ़ जाती है इफ यू नो द कीज व्हाट एग्जैक्ट कीज यू वांट टू यूज. ठीक है, देयर आर मेनी कीज व्हिच कैन बी यूज्ड टू मेक योर टास्क इजी. हियर आई कैन शो यू, सपोज आई एम वर्किंग विद दिस टेक्स्ट, आई वांट टू मेक सम चेंजेस इन द, आई वांट टू ऐड सम टेक्स्ट इन द बिगनिंग. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग लाइक दिस, आई कैन प्रेस द होम की. Instead of going like this by one cursor key से एक एक कर जाने से better है, I can press the end key. My cursor moves to the end of the line. Home key, cursor moves to the beginning of the line. Arrow key down, okay, fine. Up and down arrow key, ठीक है. To the beginning of the line, home key. To the end of the line, end key. Or if you want to move to the beginning of the document or you want to add some text at the last. Main ye kuch editing kar rahi thi, maine kar li. Now I want to add some text that should be at the last of the text. अब इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग वन पेज डाउन डाउन आई कैन प्रेस कंट्रोल प्लस एंड विल मूव माय कर्सर टू द एंड ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट. Similarly, I remember something. I had not added a heading at the beginning. I want to go to the beginning of the page. I'm having 50 to 20 pages in my document, and I want to go to the first page where I want to add the heading. I can press Control plus Home. Control plus Home. That will move your cursor to the beginning of the document. Control plus End. That will move your cursor to the end of the document. Okay. Similarly, we can use the arrow keys, we can use the home key and end key separately to move your cursor to the home, beginning of the line or to the end of the line. And you can also use control plus arrow keys to move your cursor one word right or one word left. Ek ek karke nahi aa raha, word ka, pura word rekho aa raha. I press the control key and I'm using the arrow key. Now, if I press the arrow key, it will go to the U, beginning of U, then that, everything has like this. Okay. If I press the control down arrow key or up arrow key, it will moving one paragraph down or one paragraph up. Next paragraph, next paragraph, next line. Clear? So these keys, if you practice them while doing work in Writer or any other word processor, if you practice these keys, it will be easy to move cursor. Your cursor will quickly move from one place to another. Similarly, you can use the selection keys. Instead of selecting the text by using the this mouse, we can use the keys to select the text. And I mostly use the keys. कीबोर्ड माउस से सेलेक्ट करने से बेटर है कि आई यूज द एरो कीज टू सेलेक्ट द टेक्स्ट. दैट विल बी इजी, दैट विल बी क्विकर. एंड आई पर्सनली यूज द एरो कीज एंड द कीबोर्ड फॉर सेलेक्टिंग द टेक्स्ट. एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट यू कैन यूज द कंट्रोल कीज विद एरो कीज टू मूव द कर्सर. नाउ यू कैन प्रेस द शिफ्ट की अलोंग विद ऑल दोस कीज. जो कीज हमने पहले कॉम्बिनेशन देखे हैं यूज कर रहे हो आप डॉक्यूमेंट्स को कर्सर को मूव करने के लिए, अलॉन्ग विद दैट एड द शिफ्ट की, उनके साथ शिफ्ट की ऐड कर दो. तो शिफ्ट की जब ऐड कर देंगे तो टेक्स्ट विल बी सिलेक्टेड. हैव आई शैल प्रेस द शिफ्ट की, ठीक है, एंड आई एम प्रेसिंग द एरो की, दिस विल सिलेक्ट वन वन कैरेक्टर. ठीक है, इफ आई प्रेस द डाउन एरो की, इट विल सिलेक्ट डाउन वर्ड्स लाइक दिस. इफ आई सेलेक्ट द press the up arrow key, it will start deselecting the text like this. Okay. Similarly, if I want to go to the select the full line, place your cursor by pressing the home key at the beginning. Okay. Maine cursor beginning pe rakh liya. Shift plus end. It will select the whole line. If your cursor is at the end or if your cursor is at the middle of some text, you can press shift plus home. From the cursor position to the home position, or shift plus end from the cursor position to the end of the line. Text will be selected. You can press the down or up arrow keys to move upward and downward. Okay. Similarly, अगर मैंने आपको पूरा whole document select करना है, you can press Ctrl plus A. Whole document is selected. You can change the font. The font color, you can give the font size, whatever changes you want. Or if you want to select the I want to select the shift ke saath use kar rahe hain, humne use ki thi pehle bhi keys, control plus right arrow key, that is one character, control plus shift plus right arrow key to the end of the word. Jaise control plus arrow key hum use kar rahe the to move the cursor like this, ek ek cursor move kar raha hai ek ek word. If I press the shift key along with that, control, shift and arrow, it will select one word. One word. Okay. And similarly, control plus shift plus arrow, go to the one word. Okay. Then shift plus end to the end of the line. I told you shift plus home to the beginning of the line. Shift plus down arrow, one line down. Shift plus up arrow, one line up. control plus shift plus down arrow. That will be, मैंने अभी control plus down arrow use किया था, तो it goes to the next paragraph. तो इसी के साथ मैंने shift की add कर दी, control plus shift plus down arrow, one paragraph down, one paragraph up. Clear? Practice these keys. जितना भी आप typing का work कर रहे हो, उसमें जरूर इसको practice करो. Similarly, you can have a control plus shift plus home to the beginning of the document and control plus shift plus end to the end of the document. If my cursor is in between and somewhere, मेरे cursor यहाँ पे है. I'm pressing the control plus home. Cursor will move to the beginning. If I press control plus shift plus home, selection will be towards the beginning. Okay? Selection will be towards the beginning, up to the beginning. Similarly, control plus shift plus end. Selection will be towards the end of the document from the cursor position. And if you want to select the whole document, you can press the control plus A. Clear? Is it clear to all of you? You can refer to the page number 128 in your books. Okay? There are many keys given for the selection and as well as for the movement on page number 127, cursor movement keys are there. You can refer to that page. Okay, one more thing important I want to tell you. Usually, when we type some text, we can insert the text anywhere that I want. कहीं पर भी हमें कहीं text की ज़रूरत है, I can insert the text, right? If I place my cursor here, I can insert the text. My cursor is जो already text मेरे पास है, that doesn't get lost, that will just shift towards the right hand side. But if I want to overwrite the text. I do not want to insert the text. I want to overwrite some word. I want to replace some word. So what I can do? By default, आपके पास status bar पर देखो एक option नजर आ रही है insert, insert नीचे bottom पे देखो जहाँ मेरा pointer है. ठीक है? This is the insert key on. If I press the insert key from my keyboard, that will get off and it will have the over option. Then if I type, it will overwrite the text. Insert key, अगर आपके keyboard पर है, then you can press it and it will switch off the insertion and you can press the, then you can type the text. Now see, नीचे देखो over आ रहा है and my cursor changes to the black. ठीक है? Now if I type anything, it is replacing. I can replace. It is not adding, it is not inserting, it is replacing. Okay. By default, aapke paas insert option on hai. Insert option, yahan par check kar lo status bar par. Agar aapko kabhi bhi lag raha typing mein, aapko lag raha ki mera text overwrite ho raha, insert nahi ho raha, check on the status bar whether it is insert or whether it is over. If it is over, press the insert key again. Now insertion on, cursor changes and status bar par aapko insert likha hua nazar aa raha hai. Okay? Anji, any doubt? Any doubt till now? You can ask me.